years after the Soviets liberated the death camp, anti-Semitic symbols are still very much a part of today, of the now. We have Situation Room anchor Wolf Blitzer, who is the son of Holocaust survivors. His grandparents were murdered at Auschwitz, and he went to Auschwitz in 2014 for an emotional visit.
Said Arbeit macht frei.
Work will set you free. Meaning was that that was a place for working, which was not.
It was for slave laborers.
Yes, that is, it was this kind of camp. But work was an instrument of extermination of prisoners here.
It's one thing to learn about the Holocaust in school or from books. But to see these places firsthand, some untouched since the war, can be overwhelming. Most of the Jews who were brought here came by cattle car.
And then began selection.
Mm-hmm. Who lives and who dies?
Exactly.
In my particular case, my grandparents died here.
Probably they were driven right around the costume. People who walked in, they really believed they were in shower.
So they thought maybe they were going to get a shower. But instead,
that was the gas chamber.
Before we leave Poland, we visit the only Jewish cemetery still left in the town of Auschwitz. And I see a tombstone that says Blitzer. I don't know if this woman was related to me. But I do what my father would have wanted. I say the special prayer for the dead, the Kaddish.
And Wolf Blitzer is with us now. Wolf, you said in the commercial break, did I remember this piece that you did? And I will tell you, you and I have seen many stories over the course of our careers. That is one of the ones that sticks with me the most, is watching you and your personal experience there. And, you know, just how much this means to you and to your family. It's not an abstraction. So when you saw this image of someone wearing a Camp Auschwitz shirt at the Capitol, knowing that there's this affiliation within people who were storming the Capitol, I wonder what you thought.
You know, it's so sad. It's so sad, and I'm unhappy that my parents are no longer living, but to a certain degree, I'm happy that they're not seeing what's going on here in the United States right now with this resurgence of neo-Nazi slogans and t-shirts and, you know, what we saw in Charlottesville when those individuals were walking around, Jews will not replace us, Jews will not replace us. It's always hard for me to believe that here in this country, which gave my parents freedom, they were allowed to come to Buffalo, New York after World War II. They survived the war. Their parents were all murdered. They lost brothers and sisters, uncles and aunts. But they came, the United States let them in and gave them an opportunity in Buffalo to thrive, and they clearly did thrive, and they were the most patriotic Americans I ever knew because of this moment, this opportunity they got. They were teenagers basically during the war. They survived the war in slave labor camps.